At the beginning of the Cold War, the USSR had a small panic attack at the thought that America might already have a crucial and decisive trump, gained by the possible discovery, study, and ultimately the replication of alien technology such as the one retrieved from the infamous Roswell crash site. So the Russians put a lot of effort themselves into searching for similar artifacts, hoping they would find something even better than their foes. The first logical place to search would be Egypt, which is filled with mysterious structures like the pyramids, the even older Sphinx, or numerous ancient tombs they keep discovering even today. Egypt was an ally of Russia, so the KGB asked the local services if they have any information regarding anything remotely close to what they were seeking. The Egyptian authorities said they have no real information, but have heard a story about the tomb of the visitor god, told to them on the deathbed by two Bedouins at a local hospital. They were said to have accidentally found the tomb of an extraterrestrial being and just after going inside became suddenly sick and had to be rushed to the nearest emergency room. The Bedouins didn't survive the mysterious brutal illness, but before they died they confessed to the whole experience. Upon receiving this intelligence, the USSR rapidly assembled a crew made out of scientists, archaeologists, and military staff, who were sent to Africa where they would team up with a similar Egyptian team to look for the site. All this is confirmed by Viktor Ivanovich, a scientist from Russia who had permission to study some classified intelligence files. There is no doubt that a small group of Russian scientists with military experts have discovered a tomb in Egypt in 1961. But in the documents it has never been revealed exactly what was found inside the sarcophagus. Only sources of the highest ranks of the KGB know that we have found the remains of an alien creature that died in Egypt 10,000 before Christ. The binational mission was a success and the team not only located the tomb, but also recovered a vast amount of artifacts. Reports between high-ranking KGB officials show that no less than 15 crates of such unknown wonders were retrieved from the visitor god's tomb. The tomb's walls were also full of hieroglyphic markings, which a team of both Russian and local Egyptologists worked tirelessly to first copy and then translate. Among paragraphs that could be translated are tales of the return of a foreign god, pictured with large wings. The team also reported a shield or barrier holding them back like it was protecting something or someone. We don't know who or what. During the inspection of the walls, we noticed a strange repulsive force coming out of the walls. We could not find any scientific explanation. The big amazement came at finding the visitor god's resting place and mummified remains. Its size is considerably larger than a normal man's, and it would have probably been even greater while alive. Mummification drastically reduces bodies. The remains were carbon tested and are believed to be approximately 13,000 years old. Egypt's ancient mythology tells us that the first dynasty was spawned by Osiris, who was part man and part god and came down to earth aboard a flying vessel. This is clearly not a prophecy but the description of a UFO encounter, as they had no knowledge of such things back then. If so, the KGB could have stumbled upon the body of our real creator. There's also video footage of the expedition that you can find below, which experts have mostly declared valid and unforged. Being from the 60s, it's black and white and shows archaeological digging in detail. The film is said to be received by a Russian third party with private access to secret security files. For a few seconds you can see crew members were in a hurry to exit the room, as toxic gas is spread when the coffin is opened and one member even told the cameraman to stop filming and get out. A smaller team later returns wearing protective gear. Many years later, we still don't know exactly what technology or secrets they uncovered or who the body actually belonged to. Your opinion is?